Hey everyone, today we are going to be doing this look. It's like a glitter liner and red lips tutorial. More of like a classic pinup look with a glitter twist on it. And I hope you guys like this. I'm going to zoom in now so you can see the glitter eyes actually. Because from this far, I don't think you'll be able to see glitter as such. So yes, this is the whole look that I came up with. Obviously, you can tone it down by using a neutral lip. But I just somehow like how this lips, these lips look with this look. I hope that was right, but I'm gonna zoom in so you can actually see the glitter liner, after which we're gonna start with the tutorial. I hope you can see the glitter flecks. I'm trying to move around a little so you can see how gorgeous that glitter looks, but the camera is not able to do justice to it. Some things do look better in person and this is just one of them, but yes, do keep on watching to know how to get this. So I have a rough idea of what I want to do, but it's nothing like concrete, and a lot of times what we think and what actually happens differs a lot. So I'm just going to go with whatever I feel like. So the first thing I'm going to do today is I'm going to use Jafra Brightener, Skin Brightener. I already have a review on this. If you want, I'll link it here or in the bottom bar, but it will be somewhere there, so don't worry about that. So I'm just going to use this Skin Brightener. It looks like this from the inside, and this is going to be my base for today. Let it absorb into my skin for like 5-10 seconds so it's not on the above layer, but it just goes inside and just benefits my skin like yay. Next, I'm going to use Maybelline Lumi Touch Dream Concealer to conceal the redness going around and any other flaws that needs to be concealed. I'm going to blend this all out using a Oriflame brush. It's like a blush brush sort of, but I'm just going to like blend it all out using this. Oh my gosh, this is having such bad fallouts. Didn't see the fallouts coming. Well, although I did blend in the concealer well, but it just left hair all over my face. Different story. Yeah, right now I look weird because a concealer is supposed to be a little lighter than your skin tone, and you look all weird with lighter things on, so don't worry about that. That's gonna go away in a while. Next, I'm gonna use Skin 79 Super BB Plus and Real Techniques buffing brush to just buff this into my skin, and I'm just going to take some of it on the back of my hand and just going to buff it, as I said. Giordani Gold Pressed Pearls with the help of an Oriflame big brush, and somehow this doesn't have fallouts but that one did, and I'm just going to swirl my brush into this and I'm going to bronze like the sides of my face. Next, I'm going to use LA Teen Glow Compact with the help of an e.l.f. complexion brush, and I'm just going to set under my eyes and some other areas which needs setting, otherwise they'll crease. Next, using the same complexion brush, I'm going to go in with MAC Divine Desire, which is like a beautiful blush, and I'm just going to like touch my brush with it, not even like rub it in, but just touch my brush because this is very pigmented, and I'm just going to apply this on the apples of my cheeks. lightly. You don't need to have a heavy hand with this. We just need a flush of color, nothing else. So just apply a pink blush onto your apples of the cheeks. Next, I'm going to move into my eyebrows, and I'm using Lakme eyebrow pencil, and I'm going to use an old spoolie. Like, I have this old mascara which I finished off, and so that the spoolie is clean. You can use any clean mascara wand, or if you have like that wands that come in, then those are great as well. So I'm just going to use the eyebrow pencil and then brush through my eyebrows with this mascara wand. Whether I did or did not go a little heavy on the eyebrows, I did. The look requires it, at least what I have in mind requires it. But you can totally tone it down if you don't like heavy brows. Like, brow game on. So yes, if you don't like heavy brows, you can totally tone it down. But I am all for heavy brows, not like bushy eyebrows, but heavy eyebrows. So with that, we finished the face makeup. Now I would do one of the eye, and then I'll return to show you how to do the other eye. The first thing that I'm going to do today is I'm going to apply Inglot under eye makeup base. It's like an eye primer. It's like an eye primer, sorry. And I'm just going to pick it up on my ring finger like so, and I'm going to apply it all over my eyes because I want the eyeshadows to stay all night long. Use Meet Matte Eyeshadow Palette, and I'm going to use Matte Ramirez. The first shade is going to be Matte Ramirez, which is a dark brown, and I'm going to pick that up on a dome shaped brush like so, and I'm just going to put it into my crease like a cut crease, but not actually cut crease because we are going to blend it, but I'm going to put it like that. Something like this, you want to use a blending brush. I'm using an angular blender brush from Eco Tools to just blend all this out. Everything is blended out, it's going to look something like this. Next, I'm going to pick up Matte Gallagher, which looks like this, and I'm going to use a petite eyeshadow brush from Eco Tools. I'm going to put it all over my eyelid. You can leave it like this as well because the primer acts like a nude eyeshadow, but I'm just going to put on Matte Gallagher. The same brush, I'm going to pick up Matte Chung, which is like a pale pink color. Like, it's not actually pink, but it's going to be a beautiful highlight. So I'm going to put that in my inner corners as well as under my eyebrow. I was about to say eyebrow bone, and then I'm like, what? But yeah, under my eyebrow to highlight my brow bone. I use Streetwear Color Rich Liquid Eyeliner to line my eyes. I'm going to make a heavy winged liner. So let's just make it without speaking, because speaking would disrupt me, and if I get disrupted, then my wings would be uneven, and I don't want that. I really don't want that. Just drying, I'm going to put on Kajal, and I'm using L18 Kajal today. It looks like this, and from the inside like this, and I'm just going to apply it onto my waterline. Deborah Milano Volume Sprint Mascara because I really don't want much curl or anything going on. I just want my lashes to be black. Once that is done, I'm going to pop on some false eyelashes because I haven't used one in a while and I don't want to forget the 10% of how I know how to apply it. I've popped on the eyelashes, here comes the fun part. I'm going to use e.l.f. eyeliner in Stardust. It's like a glitter eyeliner and I'm going to line my eyes like wherever I have lined it with the liquid liner. I'm going to top it off with this glitter liner to just make everything so much more prettier. Left for us to do is the lips. You can go for nude lips, but I'm going to go for a crazy color. I ordered this Rimmel lipstick in 164 in Tantrum a while back. I haven't still used it, it's new. So I'm going to use it today and see how it fares. I hope this color looks good on me. Not too sure though, and that's the reasons why you shouldn't have snacks in between of filming. You get stuff all over your face. But yes, today I'm going to use Tantrum 164 by Rimmel and just see how it looks on my lips. Look, I hope you guys enjoyed this. You can totally tone it down up to a million times by wearing a nude lip, but I think this red lip looks also awesome with this, and the eyes look irresistible with the glitter on and just so awesome. So yes, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you did, then please rate, comment and subscribe. It would mean a lot to me. And yeah, well, I have a Twitter and an Instagram, a Facebook and a blog. Links to all in the bottom bar, so make sure to check those out as well. And if you try out this look, then don't forget to tweet or Instagram it to me. I love to see you guys' recreations, and I will see you on Monday. Till then, take care. Bye.